So next one is your, that is your prevention of your heart disease. So certain diseases are there from the birth, so that we cannot prevent it. Okay. So after after birth, whatever what kind of dysfunction is there in the heart, okay, or structural structural deformities are there, we can prevent that, or after within the medications, or we'll go for medication or heart surgery or even a heart transplant also. Okay, but heart transplant is not a at last, it's the final one. So in that case, there is the survivability chances is very low. Okay, so that heart one recipient will be there and one donor will be there. The recipient will have the heart disease. Okay, so we will find a, you need to find a, you need to take. So if as we know, we have the one single heart. Okay, so if you are taking the heart of one person, then you will be die. So after that, within a certain interval of time, you can able to retrieve it from that person. Okay, or you need to take out it and we need to transplant it to the a particular recipient. So other types, however, that is we can prevent by means of your following measure, following measures. That is, eat a balanced diet. We need to take a balanced diet. Stick to the low fat. We no need to take the high fat content food. High fibers would be there, so that your food can be digested easily. Okay, and proper absorption is there. Okay, if you need, if you take the high fiber food, then your that is your, for example, fresh fruit, vegetables. Okay, you need to take green vegetables, okay, fresh fruit, so that we can maintain the function of the heart properly. So increase intake of the whole grain. Okay, we need to, no need to take the carbohydrate part. Okay, so amount of salt and sugar should be controlled. Okay, so we need to take one is your unsaturated fatty acid. Okay, so no need to take your saturated fatty acid. You can after, you can rather than you can take the unsaturated one. So in the refined tail, you have the refined oil, you have that percentage of saturation and unsaturation. If the unsaturation percentage will be there, you need to take the refined oil in which you will get a higher percentage of your unsaturated fatty acid as compared to your saturated fatty acid. So saturated, you need to minimize the saturated fatty acid concentration. So what is the difference between saturated and unsaturated fatty acid? So saturated means it is the containing, that is a bond, single bond, and unsaturated means that is a single, double, both single and double bond. Okay, so that saturated fatty acid cannot be digested easily, but you can digest the unsaturated fatty acid easily. So saturated fatty acid, for the saturated fatty acid, we cannot digest easily, so proper digestion won't be there. So that will leads to deposition of fat in our body. So that will leads to cardiac failure and heart disease. Okay, so exercise regularly. So we need to exercise regularly in order to control our cholesterol level and blood pressure. Okay, so another one is your obesity is the main reason to the heart disease. So we need to check our body weight and BMI. What is that BMI? And that is the ratio of your body weight at that of your what? Height. Height to body weight is the, that is your BMI, basal metabolic index. Okay, so you need to check it. One most important, smoking. Smoking causes severe cardiovascular disease. Okay, so we need to quit the smoking. Okay, and another thing, your, that is your alcohol. Okay, alcohol consumption is very bad for your health of the heart, so that we can minimize or quit the alcohol. Okay, so it's a recommendation what is the amount of alcohol you can take, but rather not to take it. It's better to not to take the your alcohol. Okay, so that you can able to so don't take alcohol, so that you can able to check your heart disease. Okay, so you can have a your good health of the heart. Okay, So control condition that affect heart health as a complications. Okay. So for example, high blood pressure, diabetic, we need to control our blood pressure, both systolic as well as diastolic. We need to control the, that is your pulse of the, there is a normal, we need to maintain the normal pulse. We need to control the diabetic. We need to check the blood glucose level regularly. Okay, so that we can prevent the heart disease or severe complications in the heart disease or heart. Okay. While these steps don't completely eliminate the risks of the heart disease, they can improve overall health. Okay. So the greatly reduce the chances of heart complications. So these are the certain prevention measure is there, like diet, exercise, health, that is your weight, body weight, maintenance of your body weight, quit smoking, quit alcohol, or reduce the intake of alcohol, then control conditions, other heart, other parts of the body which is associated with the heart, you can also take care of that also. Okay. So if you go to the statistics, this is the heart disease is the most or that is a devastating disease that is occur all over the world. Okay, India also now it is having the serious heart disease. Okay, the health burden placed by the heart disease on US economy is around that is your US dollar $200 billion. Okay, so every country is spending, that is a, this is the major economy. So the if most of the portion of the country will having the heart problem, then the your economy also will be degraded. Okay, so these are the following data which we need to have in our mind so that we can have a proper strategy to maintain the health of the heart. Certain news are also there. Okay. So certain conferences are there. Okay, certain research activities are going on for in order to check that. Nowadays what happened, new heart diseases are coming. Okay, so that we need to prevent that one. If there is a proper research work is there, proper medications should be found for the proper maintenance of the heart. Okay.